Yeah, Smart Wargames here. Let's check out Horse and Musket Volume 1, Frederick the Great, Friedrich der Große, Matrix Slytherin. Despite being not so old, unfortunately discontinued. And also, despite the fact that it is working absolutely fine on modern OS. Yeah, so it is, I already checked it out and will show you, it is quite a unique and great game. Not many others, you won't come by many others that are like this. And yeah, I recommend you to check out here Sturm und Drang's YouTube channel, will put his link into the description. Also a fan of exotic classic war games, modern as well, and yeah, give him a visit. Yeah, I hope you can find a copy of this somewhere. And good news is that if you hit the forum, it is still somewhat active. Also the mods and scenarios section, yeah, last post just a couple of days ago, there's a Swedish scenario pack coming with a DLC sized add-on, even a campaign included. At least it was planned here. If it is already released, can't say. But if you go through this form, you will find a lot of graphics, mods, additional battles. Yeah, there was a volume 2 planned, but my information is it was never done. Name volume 1 indicates there must be also volume 2, but it was never finished. Yeah, so check out many, many others here. Unit portraits for Sachsen. Before those links also might disappear. Good, let's check the manual. 90 pages, that is impressive for tactical battlefield war game. Yeah, it is turn-based, activation-based. I will show it to you. It resolves around initiative, different phasing. And yeah, the visuals are very appealing. As I mentioned, the game is not even that old. It comes with very unique ideas, especially for hex gaming. Yeah, looks nice, like a nice read. Yeah, scenario editor. Let's head into the folder. So, there is a scenario editor allowing you to create maps with different units rather quickly. And yeah, some nice controls. And yeah, let's check the game itself. Yeah, I'm running at higher resolutions. One thing I've noticed, this game is sensitive to DPI scaling. So if you have in Windows DPI on 150% due to higher resolution, You will have some rather displaced text in-game. Yeah, so I mean, there's sometimes a setting which you can override if you don't want to switch it manually. Yeah, here, DPI settings, etc. Yeah, so a game is forced to run at whatever 100%. You should run this game. Either switch down your DPI scaling or this extra solution. Yeah, I guess online is not really a thing anymore, but PBM is a thing. Yeah, you can play. It's not even the amount of battles that is the campaigns. Yeah, that is quite an amount. And if you check inside, that is like a folder. Really great. That's how everybody should do it. Yeah. It seems like they use some sort of editor where you quickly place. I wouldn't even mind that to have it that detailed, but at least give some visual basic idea of what battle this is. Really nice, yeah, because you're often throwing games at with dozens of battles and have absolutely no visualization of it. Nice, yeah. So this is basically major battles or aka campaigns involving different situations. Or battle groups called. Yeah, we can go through all of them to give you an idea of the amount. And yeah, as I mentioned, there might be many more custom scenarios. Really nice quality for a Hex wargame. Yeah, and this discontinuation, I mean, there's no other game like this, not even on a Matrix Slytherin store, but also on other places. I know it's not only about not giving a damn, yeah, there's sometimes other, for us, not visible reasons why something like this might happen. Sometimes you have contracts like you're allowed to publish a game for, I don't know, 5 years, and if this is not extended, you basically need to discontinue the game. But also from the developer side, somehow everybody disappears and mistreats their games as we don't give a damn. Absolutely functional, not even that old games disappearing. I don't know any other genre almost where something like this is happening. In other genres, they even maintain some crappy games. You can find them in some whatever retro places. In a wargaming community, good games, bringing you unique content. Yeah, Frederick the Great in a Hex strategy game, simply disappearing, despite being not that old. Absolutely functional on probably all current OS, disappeared. That is something not only I noticed. Good, that was the content, and yeah, let's check out a really huge battle, and then I might play something smaller here, which I already picked, and yeah, that looks like a nice limited action. So there's again a nice collection of smaller action and extreme big battles. We can here check Hohenfriedberg. And yeah, you can play here PBM, that should be fine. Remote, I guess nobody really cares to play remote. On the other hand, this is a game rather fast-paced. which might be pretty good in remote, but not sure if that is working without this online support, because online is here some login system. But who knows, perhaps it is working over Avate host. Is it an IP or what? Yeah, good, that might be possible. I was thinking that is here some login system. Yeah, so might be possible. Carl Maximus Gandhi. Oh, okay, not. And then you input the LAN address or whatever, and you can connect with each other via some VPN software. Yeah, could also work, sure. Which one would here? This one, Hohenfriedberg. Yeah, that looks quite big. That one I wanted to check out. Yeah, and computer. Let's play against the computer. Complexity expert. Yeah, perfect. Show you how big this game can become. A scale might be different from battle to battle, is here mentioned, really good. 100 yards and 15 minutes per turn. Yeah, and that game has, for example, what I talked about. Those games that allow to zoom without this fake zoom, what I call it. Yeah, basically, super allowing you to zoom. Great, great. Yeah, there's many. Why not? Nice, nicely done. That is how. That is a 2D sprite based game with a zoom added and extremely convenient. What others not manage, even to this very day. So yeah, this battle is huge, yeah? That is extremely huge. That is rather something for PBM. And yeah, this game, we are currently in a bombardment phase, which there's a lot of bombardment, a lot of artillery units. I mean, we can pick a couple of targets, but I won't do everything. Yeah, look at this nice here line of fire. There's an enemy in front of us, right? And then give them some. Right into the center. You can assign here Arty. Can also turn units in this phase. No, in this phase you're not allowed. Tooltips. Everything what a modern game needs. Modern X game. Good, we have more. Let's blast some of those guys. Nice controls. Let's fire some counter arty. Yeah, and that's it. I really like this zoom. That is, I don't know why others not get this done. Allow me to zoom as much as I want. Good. Yeah, you can click on every single one. We will auto resolve. Yeah, casualties happening. Unfortunately, can't zoom in right now. But there's normally a value, of casualties inflicted. But you can also read it here. figure it's also possible to turn it a bit faster. I'm not sure if it was only animations which can be sped up or also this here. But yeah, it's a quite big battle. So yeah, now I can show you. Now we have some commanders here which are allowed to give subordinates initiative. Yeah, this game is based on initiative. Every leader has an initiative or a command rating, which dictates when he's moving. Yeah, so it is not one of those classical turn-based game. I think that is also sometimes simply lacking. The entire army can move while the others are just sitting and doing nothing. That's why you often see facing in those games tries to represent some realism. And yeah, this here is one of those games that work with command ratings and initiative. So it could be that this element will be activated first, do something, then this element, yeah, and then this, etc. And then you have some dynamic, like in a real-time system. So, and for this, superior commanders are allowed to distribute command points that I guess represents some sort of giving further resources to those commanders and etc. Yeah, and I, for example, will spend, I'm currently selected here, General der Infanterie, I think, General der Infanterie Kalkstein, I guess, Gen Inf, will give here Generalleutnant Hochses two of my points to make sure that this guy can activate here against those quite close elements and start to push. But we will play another scenario that is really huge because resolution will take here ages. On the other hand, it is activation based, so I can show you some combat without waiting 10 minutes for becoming active. Good, that's it for this commander, but we have more. Okay, we have here Feldmarschall Prinz Leopold. And he is in command of some Generalmajor Blankensee. This is kind of command of these elements, I guess, which are still marching. And this guy is, I guess, responsible for the center. Yeah, Jimmy, you should be good here in reaction. You have a lot of commanders here to attend, Prince. And yeah, nice controls. Yeah, toggle off, toggle on. You immediately get the information who is here. This here, Feldmarschall, responsible for two commanders. Let's split those 2 points even. This Jimmy, responsible for many commanders. Who is that? König Frederick, that's Friedrich. Or Frederick, yeah. Yeah, that is here the name of the game. He's basically responsible for the entire battlefield. He's the highest commander, so he can give command points to every commander on the map. Yeah, I will not random spend those points. Cool, you got it going. Did you have any issues with getting it working Windows 10? I recall some folks did. No, absolutely not. Boot it up. I mean, I won't tap out. Not sure how the game behaves on the tap. On the other hand, I want to play another battle anyways. So if it would crash, wouldn't be that bad. But I want to show you one activation. Yeah. So now we can. And I mentioned you in the beginning, Sturm und Drang. Yeah, and you can activate leaders. You can also defer to somebody else. It is like some tactical World War II games. Units that once are activated and did something are unavailable for the rest of the turn. So the idea is that every unit will move once in a turn, but in what fashion and order, that is then determined by initiative. And leaders can also fail activation. If they have bad C2 command and control, here activate, I will now try to activate. I could also say no. Let's try it later. I want you to stay put, which isn't even a bad idea. Yeah, I want to see, for example, what my enemy will do. Yeah, I might not even activate here. But if I wanted to go on offensive quickly, attack those guys, I might do that. Let's do it now here for the showcase reasons. However, that is not even the element I want to activate. I wanted to go for Truches. That is, this guy is, I think, responsible for the outmost left flank. Prince Leopold, yeah, he's somewhat mixed because he's a superior. He will activate per command radius, it seems. Not really going to do. And somebody else activated, and yeah. Some calf unit activated. Now we are asked to activate Dumoulin, which wouldn't be even a bad idea. Here on the right, we could push this calf unit. We seem to be having here a superiority, but we have infantry. Calf-wise, we are not in the... don't have advantage. But yeah, we could, for example, pull a calf back here in order not to be endangered by a charge on the right flank. But no. Let the enemy do first. Hello, Fadi. This girl is responsible. Yeah, that is here Rotenberg, responsible for the center. That is Kev, right? Center. And not really center, that is the center. Or the right, or whatever you want to call it. That is a Kev, which we could deploy in the center, which they already have counter deployed here as well. Neutralizing deployment. Could meet here for a Kev battle. Let's. Together with, where's Leopold, here, King Frederick, join us. Let's decide if it's a calf battle, and then everybody goes home. You know, like in this, like here, 101, and then both armies go home. Good, no. Indeed, fair. That would be an element which we could activate. And... yeah, come on, let's activate something, because then I can show you the intuitive stuff here. On our end, I can also do it in gameplay. Now I quickly want to check out if I can tap out of the game without crashing. Yeah, even... is the game looking so different? No. Even that is working. Yeah. Really a shame, pulling an absolutely fine, unique, quality game. This is only happening for, not only, but really often happening in the wargaming genre. People saying it's so niche, we're not getting enough and whatever, and then throwing games out of the window. Yeah, I have here no compatibility settings, runs fine. On Windows 10, 64-bit, nothing done. It is absolutely fine. My only disappointment is that the Battle of Zorndorf is not included. I suppose a Volume 2 was planned but never done. Yeah, I also heard the same. Did you check the Matrix forums or other forums? For for the battle being perhaps part of a mod custom scenario battle add-on. Good, that's how huge can it go. Now you might say, well, that is quite huge. But yeah, you won't find that many games that take it serious. And this might be a blast to play in multiplayer while not being a slog. You see, it is rather fast-paced, moving out stuff, but not being some slog. For example, games like, which are also rather on a serious side, yeah, like Scourge of War. Yeah, I'm also a fan of Scourge of War. And they're pretty sure multiplayer very fun, because single player, they're also fun, but often the AI reduce the fun because they're simply too stupid. But it is of course a slog. Those bigger battles can take their ages, while here it seems to be you could play on one evening even a bigger battle and have some progress perhaps. Yeah. Good, we wanted to play here the first and something smaller, I guess that is here. Yeah, beginner, perfect. And we will play Preußen versus Österreich. Actually, is already selected for computer. And it's options. Yeah, that is your options, what you can do. Music is deactivated. There's some nice music, but again, I don't know, it can trigger copyright. Here, 1 second. So some quality music that will give you here some nice immersion. Max units per unit, if you want to have less clutter or want to play something like Advanced Squad Leader, where everything is represented by one guy or three guys on the map, you can do that. Here, fast animations. It's already on. So yeah, guess there's no speed setting. Good. Have you played any of the People General Total mods? The 7 Year War and Napoleonic mods are nice. I just put up a Battle of Talavera on my channel today of People's Generals. Yeah, I made a video on them and I indeed tested some of them out. Also some of the open general mods. I mean, they are of course more fast-paced and simpler, I guess, than something like this. But yeah, that is People's Generals, so nice mods. There's this one page that still maintains those mods. Same for Open General. Yeah, I tested them out. Was thinking about playing something Napoleonic. Or there's also some wars never seen in video gaming, which you can find across those PG games. Good, first there's a bombardment resolution phase, which we can auto-calculate simply. We have no RT, but the enemy has. It's already targeting us. And will now blow us up. Morale hit. 15 casualties. That was quite more casualties. Good, command turn. Here, Prince Leopold is on the scene and there's not many commanders. There's only 2 commanders available. Generalleutnant Jeetze and Baron Münchhausen. Here, Münchhausen, which is known for his telling of his crazy stories. At least that is what this tells. I don't know if the historical Münchhausen was, but I read once about this. It is, I think, not really confirmed, but not denied either, if Münchhausen was really telling some of those crazy stories, like the riding on a cannonball and whatever. Who knows? He was just joking around and some guy with a basement understanding of humor was not getting it. I don't know. but pretty sure that there were guys back in the days that were absolutely nuts. Yeah, so that is a given. Yeah, I wouldn't be even that surprised. Good, let's give, I think Jeetze, yeah, and Münchhausen also. Münchhausen perhaps even more. He's rating 6. This guy has Hori 8. You give me my command points back. That give you. Give me a chosen one. Good. Yeah, that's a nice art. I mean, it looks so good. This game needs to be. You could sell this for. I sometimes don't understand. I mean, somebody must have those rights. Are you telling me those guys all disappeared? That is really so, need to mention it again, yeah. But I don't know what is it going on. I mean, if I would produce a game like this, doesn't matter if it is, but I would somehow treat it as a as some work of yeah, labor and love, and I don't know. Don't throw it simply into the darkness for never being a mod. Yeah, could sell this for 5 to 10. Either on Steam or Matrix, people would buy that. Tell me another game that is like this, offering the stuff that this game is offering. Not many are there. Yeah, not sure if I want even to activate. Perhaps let's wait and see what the Austrians will do. Wait and see. Nah, come on, let's go aggressive here. I want to show you something here, because I won't play the entire battle. So let's activate Jeetze. Good, he succeeded. Movement phase. Now I will show you something almost no hex game ever did. Look at this. You can make group movement. Why others game can't pull that off in so many years, I don't know. Why can't I, in many hex games, simply select a group and move them as one piece? That would save millions of clicks, millions of mouses would rejoice. Yeah, here you can do that. At least, yeah, you need to watch out. That is, no, this happened to me. Wait, I can undo. Thanks. Yeah, it's a bit. I would, for example, like a selection box. Perhaps this one. No. That is for a missed opportunity, for example. I need to hold a mouse that is but better than nothing. Yeah. There's an active unit. Yeah, seems like they have mixed movement, so I will stop here. You guys join those ranks. You join. Ah, wait, we have here some in the south, some. Those guys not activated. Ah, wait, I have 2 units activated. This turning around happens sometimes to me. It's turning. Yeah, it's not perfect, it's multi-hex select, yeah, but I like that somebody put the idea. I mean, if they would improve it a bit with simply a selection box, perfect. There is really many hex games, you need to move those units by units. You want to stick in formation simply. You want to move forward a formation. Still, you need to do 100 clicks to get a super simple thing done. Like moving a line of, like this forward. You need to press 20 times. While nobody ever had the idea or the skills, basic UI skills, to simply select multiple hex units and then move in one. Since 40 years. That's why I was rather impressed to see it here. But it's not perfect. Yeah, this feels sometimes a bit rough, especially with this. You need to hold the mouse button selection. That could have done way better by simply a selection box. Theo, this. Yeah, that's. I guess most of those Scotnuts are multi-select. What is that? Never seen. I use single select. And nobody cared. Pretty sure. I think the last unit is in the active unit, or can I switch? Ah, here. Yeah, like in other games, you can switch who is the active unit. And then pull this off. Isn't that amazing? Yeah, Jimmy, you want to see the battle? No, I'm watching from here, it's fine. Okay. Are you guys selected? Okay. Yeah, can you do something? Change formation? Turn left, turn right. No, don't do that. What is your range? 1. Okay, what have they for a range? 1. No, we won't. I mean, we can activate Prince Leopold in order to get him closer. And I think he's also. No, he's not responsible for those units. He can command units as well as a higher up. But I'd rather. And that's at least. I don't know how they handled it back in the days. I think it was different. Nowadays, you wouldn't, of course, micromanage the units of your subordinate. That is what noobs do in commanding. Because they can't figure out how to distribute responsibility. Okay, let's activate. I want to be here at the side. You watch out for your horse. Failed activation. Good, here, Münchhausen, activate. Jimmy, don't fail. Nice one. Wait, select all. If that is working, this game will be showcased. I will create a community. Okay, yeah. Jimmy, that is 5 stars alone. Hand it out for this game. I don't care anymore. 5 stars. You can select the leader, select all units, and he selects the entire order of battle. And then you can make some unit active, like this here. You should use a corner. And do that. This was designed definitely by somebody that values time. Yeah, that has perhaps also other hobbies. And is thinking. Not thinking, let me spend 10 years with clicking because I have nothing better to do. It's some really of the best stuff I've seen long in a hex game. Yeah, it's looking basic, but find other games that have this stuff. Yeah, good luck. There might be some, but few. And then it makes it feels fun to play. There's so many of those hex battlefield games or whatever in ancient times, and it feels like a slog to move those units around. To keep formation, etc. It feels, you know, you see the army and you know, boy, you already start to count those clicks. Clicking there, clicking there. Every unit, 10, 5, 7 clicks, and here, select the leader, move forward, they stay all in formation. Isn't that beautiful? Is that so hard? Why is this game discontinued? It should be handed out as a free copy to some of those developers to see how it is done. That's how I would do it. Perhaps that's why it was pulled off store in order not to shame the others. Nah, just joking. Yeah. But yeah, impressive. Good, the first turn is over. Turn 1 of 10. Yeah, they will again fire with the arty into us. Both. Into one unit. Maximizing the shock value. I guess they plan to impact here. Or the imp... it seems like they're planning rather in the center. We might even need to retreat here, otherwise this might... It's not even a bad move by the AI. Because this unit is somewhat isolated here. And the formation is not the best. Yeah, definitely activate Leopold. Leopold, no, you don't activate. Let the commander handle it. Oh, she is flanking us here. Yeah, but what's going on? It's why so slow? Yeah, that is already on the flank, Tony. I extra waited for you. Well, if this guy would have failed... Yeah, you need to watch out if sometimes if you give away command. But I think then Leopold will come back. Yeah. If he skips, he comes back afterwards. Good, yeah, I guess we need to react to that. Jimmy, face left. Turn left. Can we then still attack? I guess not. Ah, yeah, exactly. You don't need to do that. Ah, damn it, the facing is not screwed. Thank you. Thank you, game. Also for this, 10 stars, yeah. For this undo button. Perform mode phase. That is something with formation. Line formation is always pointing towards those, right? And other formations are always pointing to the center of X. It has a reason why they do that. Need to figure it quickly out, because it is different as many other games. Because I want to fire on those guys, but I need to move close then. Yeah, I guess I want to turn to this. Then move here. I also can perform about phase. Ah, yeah, exactly. No, Jimmy, don't do that. Yeah, we are currently line, right? Yeah, that is definitely line. Good. Turn left. Better. Oh. We'll be left with 0 action points here. They're coming for our objective, but I can get some guys there in. Yeah, let them pass if they want. Pretty sure there's a button which you can do it faster, or shift perhaps. If I press now, something will happen. There's a button where, because normally you execute a move and need to hold a mouse button for, well, I'm pretty sure there's a button for that. And look at this, how beautiful that is. Isn't that a beautiful beauty here? People say, what this? Isn't that standard? No, it isn't. Unfortunately not. Good, I need somebody on the objective here, so we mark the fight here from the town. Whoa, that's quite here, movement. Can you even reach that? No. Yeah, Jimmy's here. Maut. Yeah, urban warfare. Pull off here some... Hit this building. Looks like there's a nice formation here. Oh, that they got disruption 40, yeah, but that is fine. It's a way to... Perhaps next turn I need to change the formation, but I think those guys are not... it's fine, that's how they're supposed to fight. Get him in Marsh Colonel, but that also takes again so much time. You guys. Nah, you guys already moved in, right? You can't close in. So we are done. Good, we have some combat to resolve. There's shooting phase. Let's do auto calculation. But yeah, normally you can click on every battle symbol, battle icon in order to execute it. Yeah, this is defensive fire. We moved into them, so they're now executing defensive fire. That is what? Jimmy's... You're already retreating here, what? Good. Yeah, let's target... You target this guy, so wait, perhaps those... You target him. And those guys are not in contact yet. Those guys already pushed back, unfortunately. Yeah, not the best formation here. But you made contact with... But okay. Just here for showcase how you do it. And then you should grasp the idea behind this game. It has a defensive fire and basically a second fire. I guess second fire is offensive fire, something like that. Basically, the unit that moves has always, of course, the... disadvantage to move into the fire range of another unit before being able to fire on their own effective, depending on the range of the weapons, of course. But usually a unit ready to fire, of course, has an advantage above a maneuvering element. That is here depicted by defensive fire, and then afterwards you might fire on them while having to face the first casualties. Marine also nice sounds. Pretty authentic. Just combat resolution could be a bit faster. Yeah, we could now, yeah, I mean, I show it you. Yeah? Normally you shouldn't do that, but you can, you're also allowed after unleashing a salvo, you're allowed to attack. By clicking them. Let's do here, but this won't work out. I can tell you, but just in order to show you how close assault is working. Those units we won't toggle into assault. Oh, it even worked out. Not bad. Those guys retreated before even the assault happened. And here was close combat. Camera movement, everything. The controls are amazing in this game. Some of the best controls I have ever seen, and I played on this channel, I have played most Hex war games. This has even better controls than many Vigo or real-time games. Whoever designed this, those guys are really good with this controls, etc. Beautiful. Simply beautiful. Yeah, we could push here into the center. Currently, the center is quite weak here. And Münchhausen, all in. Let's make this guy active. And is that the maximum we can ride? Yeah, because Münchhausen, they can't ride that far like you. Is that really the maximum? Unfortunately, they are not that fast. I was already thinking I can ride here, but this guy alone can ride that far. At least he'd claim so. Perhaps he would travel on a cannonball. Yeah, I guess because they are riding in a specific formation. Here you can even see who is the commander. Yeah, in line formation, I guess that slows them down. If you want to ride very fast, you need to put them in some sort of column or whatever. That is some of the best Hex Battlefield, most fun by being authentic stuff I've seen. I can't remember when I last time I played a game that does you such favors in having fun. With all those control assists. Minimizing those clicks tremendously. Good, what is going on? Leader activation. Yeah, Jimmy, Prince Leopold. I mean, you could activate those guys. Yeah, exactly. What is going on with those guys? Yeah, they're already engaged, and those guys. Jimmy, activate, I want to see what you can do. But there is nobody. They all moved already. Yeah, you can move behind the line here. Be like a commander. Fire resolution. Who is firing on who? Ah, here, okay. Yeah, right now it doesn't even look that bad. Yeah, this seems like this volley was already. Look at those controls, it's amazing. This game should normally have win the prize here. Let's create a prize. A Smart War Games Award for good programming. Competence in programming. And whoever did this controls here, this selection and multi-select, yeah, you are awarded 2022. A bit late, I know, but it was time that somebody does it. Yeah, yeah, Russian bots agreeing, NGO, non-Russian non-government organization agreeing. Jimmy, but still, goodbye. Yeah, I said I will hand out a community message because it's Münchhausen multi-select. Yeah, I need to keep my word. I always keep my word. So yeah, this here is winning the, I don't know what you want, what do we want to call it? Best programming award. Actually, that is simply amazing. What the. And I think the AI is also doing, often in those games, AI is really struggling, yeah, and especially those horse, musket and sword, yeah, Tatsio or whatever those games. But they're keeping here cohesion, yeah, it's not even about that they keep a perfect line, or do you say, yeah, wait, I could improve here this formation. Yeah, I'm talking about comparing this to Total War. In Total War, it would look like this. A single unit charges you, while the rest is running in circles, while the commander is running here into the river and drowning. That would be Total War level of AI. Here you have, yeah, they're running towards the objective, but they still have you in mind, yeah, developing here in line. Here they also prepare to fire on you. Here is also your absolute decent deployment. So the AI seems to work, yeah, it could be, of course, it's also handmade, but it seems rather that a lot of this stuff is triggered by a tech AI. Yeah, also, well done. Yeah, there's, of course, there's a Total War mod about this, and sure, it looks beautiful, but, sorry, Total War is out of off-limits for me alone of the AI, because of the AI. No matter what AI mod you install, the AI mod, they always pull out names like Godlike, Super AI, and whatever. Nothing super about them. It's only text file editing. They can't access the core because nobody accesses the core since 20 years of Total War development. They still leave the AI simply to be. I mean, in the modern games, they figured out some limitations to that. Like this limited siege battles in order to improve. But here it looks pretty decent. I'm enjoying it. Looks like some battle units not running around. Solo getting wasted, but attacking in force. And distributing forces seem to be pretty good. They basically have here created low, yeah, good here, wouldn't say local superiority here, perhaps. But it's definitely fine, yeah, but also this here, this elements with selection, everything, right-click menus. Perfect, yeah. I'm really surprised to see that in some rather unknown game. Especially those games, often, yeah, those historical games, focusing on this era, they tend to be extra tedious. Because also perhaps there are some folks that like to spend 10 hours only setting up their units, don't care if they need to do trillions of clicks. As this is rather a niche on its own, yeah, it's not Napoleonic, but it's not even Napoleonic. Napoleonic would be even more popular. But here, this this time frame. Yeah, we have targeting phase. Let's do that. we have some here nice superiority against this unit. That is first fire, and then I might move in. So there's a first fire, there's defense fire, there's second fire. There are also really nice phasing. We are allowed to fire first, then we are allowed to advance, then the enemy is allowed to defense fire, and then we are allowed to late fire. And that is fine, that is what seems to be authentic. Look at this. Click, 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 done. Beautiful. The nice thing with the zoom level that you have access to free zoom. That is not also not that often in hex games. Either you have zoom steps, which might be too much, too little, too high, too low, or you have a static zoom, which is resolution sensitive, and then you need to adjust your resolution. And sometimes it is too close, sometimes it is too far away. Yeah, this here is for example good for an overview, but sometimes you want to zoom in to see the action a bit more. Those really good looking sprites. And otherwise, then sometimes you might command here from this upper view, then you zoom in again. And this is here. Amazing. Was this at least valued back in the reviews? I hope so. Good, yeah, let's set up here. Now it's movement phase, right? Yeah. Why not here? They even turn perfect. Jimmy, man, it's too good. They're even facing correctly like I wanted. Amazing. How is it looking here? Casual device. Yeah, we took definitely more casualties. Good, now let's make full contact. This unit. Yes. Did those guys offensive fire? Oh, yeah, they're engaged, okay. They are engaged. It's whom? Gee, who are you fighting? Oh, who are they fighting? Disengage. No, it's fine if you're engaged. Would like to turn you to the left. Wait, if you're facing. But you can't fight somebody, I mean, they fire into your flank, right? Perhaps they're engaging our flank, and that's why we need to disengage. Let's see what happens. Okay, I'm not sure if that's a good idea, but. I think we were attacked here by the flank. By down. Into the flank. What happens if you put a lead on the front line? I'd rather not do that. Okay, now we will face defense fire. Yeah, I think I forgot to move this unit. Whatever, yeah, this is just here for showcase. And now late fire. Really like the phasing, makes a lot of sense. And you're either allowed to participate in the first and the second fire phase. Makes also sense, because otherwise the defense would have a disadvantage. I would fire one time less, which doesn't make sense. Yeah, this really is somewhat like here. Yeah, reminds me of Advanced Squad Leader. They have similar phasing when it comes to the firing. Come on, let's do the last thing and then I call it, because I don't want to make the video too long. As I'm pretty sure I'm already over an hour. Let's do a big charge. And that could even work out, who knows? Those poison, don't underestimate them. They're already retreating. Forget it. Yeah, but we took no casualties. Okay, that was here Horse and Musket Volume 1. Absolutely impressive in every regard. Yeah, as content wise, interface, graphics, everything looks really good. This zoom level, but absolutely impressive and probably among the best, if not the best, controls in a hex battlefield wargame, or tactical, musket and horse and musket wargame. I mean, also other wargames, hex based. Yeah, check it out. If you have the capability perhaps to buy it somewhere used or whatever, really nice. And I'm pretty sure that many would like it. Yeah, that is really feeling like a good serious board game experience. Okay, see you. Good hunting.